subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Like, comment, and share.
Alright guys, welcome to your third Photoshop tutorial, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how to create a new document. Now, this is a little bit more difficult than creating like a new document in Microsoft Word, because you just don't press File, New, and then you're good to go. There are actually a lot of settings that you need to go through before you create a document, and I'm going to be talking you guys through all of those settings right now. So go ahead and choose File, New. And like I said, unlike any other program where everything just pops up and it's ready to go, you have to answer a bunch of questions or fill out a form before you can, you know, make a new document. So the first one, name, it's easy. I'll just name this, you know, YouTube, name it whatever. Pretty much the name of your file, so whenever you save it, this is going to be the default name that it saves under. Now, right here, your next option is your preset. Now, this is generally the main option you want to focus on first, because you need to ask yourself first, what are you using this for? If you're just going to make a graphic for the web, or you know, just something that you're going to stick on a blog or something, then just go ahead and put it at default Photoshop size, and it's going to fill out the rest of these settings for you. However, if you're making like a flyer for, I don't know, maybe you're going to have a garage sale or something, then you usually want to choose US paper. Or maybe you're working on something for a movie, then you can choose film and video, and then it's going to give you some more options of your video. But just for the probably the rest of these tutorials, and just for default, you usually want to stick with default Photoshop size, and then everything is filled up basically how you want it to. So the next setting, unless you're doing anything weird, then just go ahead and stick with that. The next setting is the width and height. Now, usually whenever you're working with the web, then you want to work in pixels, but some people prefer inches. Again, if you're overseas, then you probably don't use inches and use metric instead, but I prefer to work in pixels just because, you know, I design things for websites a lot, and whenever I talk in Photoshop, I'm not like, okay, move this, make a box that's 2 inches wide. People usually say make a box that's, you know, 150 pixels wide. So that's why I prefer to work in pixels as well, but you can work in whatever, matter of preference. Now, resolution is where things get kind of tricky, because it really depends on, and really all of these things right here depend on, what is your final image going to be used for. If you're making an image that you want to use on a website or the web in general, or on your computer at all, it needs to be 72 pixels per inch. Again, it doesn't need to be, but that's the best resolution to use for the web or for a computer. If you're printing, for example, if you want to make a flyer for, you know, your garage sale, or you know, your new business, and hang it up at the grocery store, then what you want to do is you want to change this to 300 pixels per inch. So it really depends on your printer, but typically printers are 300 pixels per inch. That's going to give you the best quality. And for the web, as you see, if you ever choose default, it puts it at 72, because that's the best for images that you just view on the computer. Now, if you use anything less than 72 or less than 300 for printing, it's going to make the image look kind of pixelated and bad quality. And if you're saying, you know what, I want this image to be really good for the web, so I'm going to put this at, you know, 1000 pixels per inch, that's going to look crisp. Actually, it's not going to look crisp, it's going to look worse. And the reason that, you know, they put 72 is because that's the standard. So don't think that you know, putting like 1000 pixels per inch is gonna give you a really high quality image. It's not gonna make a difference. It's just gonna waste a bunch of memory on your computer. So remember the rule: 72 for web, 300 for print. Now, the color mode is another weird thing. You know how, you know, when Apple and Microsoft were first making their computers, they couldn't make anything compatible? This is another weird thing that the people who made like printers and computers, this added this to annoy us. RGB and CMYK are the two main color modes you're going to use. Whenever you're working with images on the computer, use RGB, and typically printers prefer CMYK. So if you ever want to print something on a piece of paper, it's probably better to use CMYK color. But since I'm making tutorials and using these pictures on the web, you typically want to stick with RGB 90% of the time. Now the other color modes, I might as well go over those, is grayscale. Pretty much means, you know, if you're making a black and white photo, you want it all grayscale. And the rest of these, lab color and bitmap. Lab stands for luminosity A and B channels, and bitmap, don't even worry about lab and bitmap right now because that's more advanced stuff. The really only thing you need to worry about in these tutorials, I'm going to be using RGB 100% of the time, and that's what people typically use unless you're doing something really weird. So just remember that, that's the main one. We'll talk about the more advanced ones in the upcoming tutorials. Now, 8-bit, don't really worry about that right now. 8-bit's fine for what we're going to be doing. The background contents are, you can make it a color, which is, you know, of course, green, blue. I typically like to use white because, first of all, even if you want your background transparent, like you're making a logo that you're going to put on a website and you don't want a background that's white, I like to make the logo with a white background anyways because it's easier to work with, and then later on when you want to save the final image, you can take the white away. So I always choose white right here, and even if you want the background to be transparent, you don't want to work with a transparent background. It looks weird in Photoshop, so you want to pretty much always stick with white right here. And I'll show you how you can remove the background really easy later on, about two clicks of the button. Now, the other things I want to go over is the advanced section. Again, this is obviously advanced stuff, so you might as well just hide that because you don't want to accidentally click anything. But the color profile, don't even worry about that right now. Whenever we talk about color management, I'll talk about that. In the pixel aspect ratio, this is pretty much, do you want your pixels to be square or not square? Pretty much 99.9% of the time you want square pixels. The only people who ever don't want square pixels is if you're working with a really weird video editing program. Some video things or some graphics that you make for videos, like titles, or I don't know, maybe just making a special effect on your video, they like pixels that are kind of stretched out, because you know how every like TV screen and every video monitor displays your image a little bit differently. But unless you really know what you're working with video, again, 99%, just leave this at square pixels. I never used anything but square pixels. So once you're done setting everything, then just go ahead and hit OK, and it creates a new blank document where you can draw on, add some text, add some images, add whatever you want. So that's how you create a new document. Again, file, new, and then fill out everything you need to. And in the next tutorial, what I'm going to do is, well, you know what, I'm not going to tell you guys because it's going to be awesome, don't want to spoil it for you. But again, a lot of these things you don't even want to touch, you just want to choose default Photoshop size and okay. But if you want to go, you know, change one thing specific to how you want it, that's how you do it. So thank you guys for